Okay, Shilin. So we have seen that chloroplast looks in appears in different shapes, that is disc, oval, ladder, spirally coiled, and in many organisms or algae or fungus, Spirogyra, if you take Spirogyra and algae. Okay, Shilin. Then what happens here, it may look like spirally coiled and all. Like, okay, Shilin. Now this is about the chloroplast. Three types. Diameter is 4 to 10 micron, and tap solar energy, which is converting into chemical energy, which is the first step for the photosynthesis to go on. Now, when we come to three types of chloroplast are of three types, children. Okay, now usually chromoplast, chloroplast, and leucoplast. Actually, we complete consider chloroplast under the plastids. We consider the chloroplast under the plastids. Under the plastids, we have then chloroplast, chromoplast, leucoplast. Okay, chloroplast. Okay, then it is like leucoplast. Then it is chromoplast. Now, when we talk about the chloroplasts, they are the one which is having green pigment. Okay, all the leaves which appear green in color, they are made up of chloroplast, because the green color of pigment chlorophyll. So we refer them as chloroplast. Now, what are leucoplast? Leucoplast are the plastids which do not have any specific colors. They are plain or white in color. Okay, leucoplast are the one which are pale in color or white in color. Now, when we talk about the chromoplast are the ones which have certain colored pigments, like we can say orange or yellow and all. Because you might have observed certain plants which appear purple in color, or which appear yellow in color, or green, I mean orange in color. These are because of the colored pigments, like carotenoid, xanthophyll and all. Yellow, the reddish color or orangish color appears because the chromoplast, because these chromoplasts are the one which contain the colored pigment. That colored pigment is giving the different color to the plants. So this is about the chloroplast. Now we have completed all the cell organelles. Now let us move to the next and the last topic of your lesson, that is, are the cells flat? Now we have discussed, of course, all the organelles and all. Now the what is the question arising is, the are the cells flat? Okay, whenever you look at the cell under the microscope, we see normally the cell looks flat, children. Okay, and it is giving a two-dimensional picture. It is giving a two-dimensional picture, and it appears as if all the cells are arranged in one plane. All the cells are arranged in one plane, like, okay, when we look under the microscope. But this was made clear after observing it under the much more powerful microscope, and it has been said that yes, the cells are not arranged in plane, and it can, the thickness of the cell can be seen. Now, when we see normally the cells, we can talk about the length of the cell, breadth and thickness of the cell, which we have discussed about the length and breadth of the cells, okay, or my cell organelles, my cells. Then what happens here is, cells, whenever we look under the microscope, they have length, breadth and thickness we are seeing. Okay, but the thickness of the cell cannot be calculated, or cannot be Okay, children, now we shall talk about the are the cells flat. Whenever we want, we observe the cell under the microscope, we see that the cells are appearing flat in nature, and all the cell organelles are arranged in one plane. Okay, all the cell organelles are arranged in one plane, and we can see the length, breadth and thickness of the cell. But actually, when we want to see the correct thickness of the cell, we have to change the focus of the microscope. That means whenever we want to see the correct thickness of the cell, we need to change the focus of the microscope and we have to reduce the intensity of the light. When we reduce the intensity of the light, then and when we look at the cell wall, then we can correlate the thickness of the cell. This is about the cells. Now we talk about the two scientists here. The two scientists here are Matthias Jacob and Schleiden in the 1804 and 1881, and Theodor Schwann 1810 to 1882. And these are the two scientists who said that yes, all the living organisms are made up of cells, and they proposed the cell theory. The cell theory is proposed by these two scientists. And Jacob Schleiden is a botanist. Botanist means to study about only the plants, its structure, functioning, and Theodor Schwann is the one who is a zoologist. Zoologist is person who deeply studies about the structure of the animals, their functions and all. So these two scientists have come together and they have studied all the organisms related to the cell structure of which are present in the plants and which are present in the animals, and they have come up with the theory and proposed the theory, cell theory, and they said that all organisms are made up of cells, whether it is a plant or whether it is an animal. But for the theory to come out, it has taken 200 years. Robert Hooke was the first person to observe the cell under the microscope. Okay, all of you know that. Robert Hooke was the first person to observe the cell under the microscope. After him, it has taken 200 years for the scientists to propose the cell theory. And these are the two successful scientists who could come out saying that, yes, all the plants and animal kingdoms are made up of cells and the nucleus. Okay, children. Then we moved on to the next scientist, that is Rudolf Carl Virchow. Now he is the scientist who said that that new cells are arising from the pre-existing cells. Okay, now if there are any damages there or any or things are there, that has to be repaired. That means the new cell has to arise, otherwise the organism, it is not called as a perfect organism. Okay, so for these things to happen, what should take place, that the new cells should get generated, and the new cells are arising from the pre-existing cells. This concept was given by Rudolf Carl Virchow. Okay, that means he has modified little bit of the theory which was proposed by these two scientists, and finally he said that yes, they all the organisms which belong to plant and animal kingdom are made up of cells. They contain the nucleus, and all the new cells are arising from the pre-existing cells. So finally we say that all the organisms are made up of cells and its products, and all the new cells are arising from the pre-existing cells. Okay children, now this is all related to your first chapter, that is cell structure and function. We have seen all the cells, what are the structure, what is the importance of each organelle, and we have discussed the functions. Each organelle has its own function to play within the cell, so that organism as such can work perfectly, or the coordination of all the cell organelles makes the organism to work perfectly. So this is about your first lesson. In next, we'll move to the next one, and I'll meet you in the next class. Okay, children? Thank you. And please go through all the cell organelles, because this is the basic what we are learning. Then in future classes, we have much more to learn. Okay, thank you.